about Warcraft, people, the thing about this movie is that a lot of people kind of saying it already kind of sucks. The thing is, does it suck? No. Sucks a little bit too strong of a word. Dragon Ball Evolution fucking sucks. The Legend of Chun-Li fucking sucks. Super Mario Brothers fucking sucks. Those things are a bit of abomination. This movie doesn't suck per se, it's just a little bit too average or at least generic. Now granted, I would give respect to Duncan Jones, and that's just the straight up truth, because this guy actually does seem like he has a lot of respect for, you know, the Warcraft lore, and especially its fans. I think he treats this shit with respect because he actually is a fan of this, and I think it actually shows. A lot of video game movies in the past, they kind of shitted on the lore and they kind of shitted on the fans, but they just try to go for something a little bit more different. This one at least kind of does two of the three right, which is pretty much please the fans, please the lore, but it doesn't really get accessible to the general audience, and I think that's kind of what the main problem is next. The problem with this movie is just that it has too much shit going on, simply put. I think this movie has a lot of things kind of going for it. Some of it is interesting, and some of it is just not, because you don't have enough character development kind of going on. There's a lot of names, there's a lot of places that kind of like thrown out there, and there's supposed to be big deals inside of the Warcraft universe from what I've been told from some people, and they just are not really that well developed. There's a lot of characters like Ben Metalif from, you know, Ben Foster, he's a big deal, but it's not really developed much. You know, there's a lot of characters in here that are just kind of not really well developed, and that's kind of the main problem. Now, granted, they do kind of set up a couple of sequels or a couple of things that are like laying the groundwork for some sequels, and that's great, right? A lot of people that kind of get a kick out of this, particularly fans, may actually find this thing quite entertaining and want a sequel. For those that don't want a sequel because they didn't care for this movie, because they didn't feel connected to anything in here, then you're not really going to give a shit. Now, Paula Patton in here is just atrocious. Not necessarily her acting, but her teeth is just terrible. Now, granted, she is kind of hot for the most part, but she's kind of like the chick that is kind of hot with a nice body, but you want to kind of put a bag over her face, but you still might bang her anyway. That's kind of like Paula Patton. The thing is about this, the performances itself is kind of okay. They're not really anything spectacular, and you're not really going to remember anybody personally, but I think this movie is visually stunning to the point where you are going to just kind of be stopping at the screen and be like, damn, this is visually well done. And I think they actually do a really good job of kind of like capturing the essence of Warcraft. The problem with this movie, though, to add on to it, is pretty much that some of the CGI with the motion capture and the CGI aspects of the film, they actually work very well. When you add in some of the human elements to the film, they do not look that well. It kind of looks a little bit like it's taking you out of the movie, that's simply put. Now, granted, like I said, I think this movie actually is fairly entertaining if you have a fantasy fix. Now, to me personally, I did kind of like this a little bit more than A Hobbit. The problem with this movie is just that it's a little bit too generic. You've seen all this shit kind of done before for the most part, and there's no real risk. I feel like they try to play a little bit too safe because they didn't know how the Warcraft brand would pretty much kind of react to kind of the general audience, and I feel like that's kind of the problem. They only rely too much for the things inside the film. They definitely are pandering to the fans, but as a movie itself, it does not really access to like a general movie going audience. It's just not that good. A lot of people are going to kind of be confused, and there's some things that just aren't really well explained, and then it kind of ends. You know, you may want a sequel, you may not, but that's just kind of how Warcraft is. Overall, I think if you're a big fan of these fantasy films, I think you may get a kick out of it. Just be prepared that you're expecting like the Lord of the Rings or shit, or like Game of Thrones type of quality, then don't. I think the biggest problem with this movie also is just it's a little bit too serious for its own good. From what I see, this thing could have been a little bit more fun, but it's just a little bit too serious, and therefore it doesn't really add up to that great of a time. Now, every movie has to be campy and fun, but I feel like this one could have added some, you know, funness to it. But I did like the mage guy, though he was actually pretty good. But overall, I think this is a decent enough fun adventure that you could probably go and see on a matinee. I wouldn't probably say you should see this full price, but then again, what do I know? I'm just a guy in a hat. Comment, subscribe, and like. I'm Chris Smith, and I'm signing out.